Good afternoon.
Good afternoon.
Welcome to St. Rose of Lima, the celebration of Mass. Please stand.
Spirit.
Good afternoon, everybody.
Afternoon, Father.
Happy to welcome you to St. Rose of Lima's celebration of the Body and Blood of Christ. What in many ways called a Corpus Christi, the Body of Christ. It's really a special feast for all of us, reminding us that we are part of the Body of Christ. That means that we are deeply associated with the life of Jesus, especially on the cross, and through his suffering, his resurrection, we become part of that. And that's an interesting fact today, as we've joined the global community in combating the pandemic. So at one time we honored Jesus in the bread and the wine, as well as in our own life and our own interior landscape. So let's think of that and call to mind our ongoing need. Despite our closeness to Jesus, we all know there's still that ongoing need for our forgiveness again and again. Lord Jesus, you are the Son of God, the Prince of Peace. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Lord Jesus, you are the Son of God and the Son of Mary. Christ, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
Lord Jesus, you are the Word made flesh. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
May Almighty God have mercy on us. Forgive us all of our sins and bring us to life everlasting.
Amen.
Glory
to God in the highest and on earth,
peace to people of good will.
We praise you,
we bless you,
we adore you,
we glorify you,
we give you thanks to your great glory.
Lord God,
Heavenly King, O God, Almighty Father,
Lord Jesus Christ,
your only begotten Son,
Lord
God, Lamb of God,
Son of God,
you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. You take away the sins of the world,
receive
our prayer.
You are seated at the right hand of the Father.
Have mercy on us.
For you alone are the Lord.
You alone are the Lord. You alone are the Most High, Jesus Christ,
with the Holy Spirit,
and the glory of God the Father. Amen.
Let us pray. O God, who in this wonderful sacrament has left us a memorial of your passion, grant, we pray, so to revere the sacred mystery of your own body and blood, that we may always experience in our own lives the fruits of your redemption, who live and reign with you, God the Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God, forever and ever.
Amen.
Again.
The response, praise the Lord, Jerusalem.
Praise the Lord, Jerusalem.
Glorify the Lord, O Jerusalem. Praise your God, O Zion. For he has strengthened the bars of your gates. He has blessed your children within you.
Praise the Lord, Jerusalem.
He has granted peace in your borders. With the best of meat, he fills you. He sends forth his command to the earth. Swiftly runs his word.
Praise the Lord, Jerusalem.
He has proclaimed his word to Jacob, his statutes and his ordinances to Israel. He has not done this for any other nation. His ordinances he has not made known to them. Alleluia.
Praise the Lord, Jerusalem.
A reading from the first letter of St. Paul to the Corinthians. Brothers and sisters, the cup of blessing that we bless, is it not our participation in the blood of Christ? The bread that we break, is it not a participation in the body of Christ? Because the loaf of bread is one, we, though many, are one body, for we all partake of the one loaf. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Thank you.
According to John.
Glory to you, Lord.
Jesus said to the Jewish crowds, I am the living bread that came down from heaven. Whoever eats this bread will live forever. And the bread that I will give you is my flesh for the life of the world. The Jews quarreled among themselves, saying, How can this man give us his flesh to eat? Jesus said to them, Amen, amen, I say to you, unless you eat the flesh of the Son of Man and drink his blood, you do not have life within you. Whoever eats my flesh and drinks my blood has eternal life, and I will raise him on the last day. For my flesh is true food, and my blood is true drink. Whoever eats my flesh and drinks my blood remains in me, and I in that person. Just as the living Father sent me, and I have life because of the Father, so also the one who feeds on me will have life because of me. This is the bread that came down from heaven. Unlike your ancestors who ate and still died, whoever eats the bread will live forever. The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ.
Please be seated. Well, today we have that long reading from the book of Deuteronomy. It's actually a beautiful book of the Jewish scriptures in the Old Testament. And in the reading today, it just goes on preparing the Israelites for more time in the desert. We know that they spent 40 years wandering. Last week I looked at this reading and I said, I wonder what God had in mind leading them for 40 years. And then when we really studied, continued the reading, we realized, well, they were constantly arguing with God. It wasn't God. It took them that long to find their way to the promised land. They had no idea how close they were to it at so many different times. It was the easiest destination in the world. They were just close because they were fighting and they were arguing and disagreeing. They're men and everybody, right? Did Moses call them a stiff-necked people? Impossible to deal with. And all they had to do was walk across the river and they would have been the promised land. But they kept doubting God. God said, let them figure it out for themselves. I gave them everything they needed to figure it out. If they can't find it, they're just going to stay there. I sort of compare those 40 years in the desert with not even 40 months of our own wandering through this murderous pandemic. And we have a lot to be grateful about, I suppose. But I think what the world needs now is a little reflection on how much we have, how much we've been given, whether or not we share that. A lot of the pandemic has a lot to do with what's wrong in each of our lives. And that's why the writers are saying already, this would be the time to deal with those things, to deal with the things that we complain about, have a sharing session with our children to remind them of how blessed they are while they complain about no graduation or too much school or all these relatively unsmall things that we know they're hard to deal with. Of course they're hard to deal with, but we can help one another deal with them together. And together makes much more sense in dealing with a pandemic than by yourself. This is not a time for passionate disagreement. This is the time for looking at what holds us together. I was looking through a couple of magazines last few days on missions, like Marion Missions and Columbia Missions. A lot of them are pictures of missionaries sort of sitting around in someone's home. It's a pretty shabby home. There's nothing to it. You know, there's four walls and maybe a ceiling if you're lucky. Dirt floor, good food on the table, I guess, for them, simple food. They're celebrating because the missionary, the priest, has come after 2 or 3 months of being aware, covering a vast area of the Philippines or some country in Africa or Latin America. And what they all share in common is they're all smiling, they're all laughing, they're all filled with joy because they're going to receive communion as soon as the mission priest finishes setting up. That's the focus of their time. They trudge over the hills and the small mountains because they heard the priest was probably going to be there. They're the type that don't even get angry if he doesn't show up. Unlike that here and other places in America, I have to say. All the priests do not show up. There's a big trouble down here. No one asks for any kind of excuse or where you've been or where you sit or anything like that. That's just what happened. But they're used to Jesus the way we have been praying earlier, in the spiritual communion. But this is two or three different magazines, all different cultures, all lonely places around the world, places like Haiti, places like the Philippines, and I've been to some of them. I've been to the Philippines, I've been to El Salvador, I've been to plenty of missionary countries, and anyone who visits them, like the people that we sent to Haiti, they always come home like, what a lesson. And maybe it's just because we don't look far enough beyond what we have. The body of Christ, our relationship to God the Father, through His Son, Jesus Christ, by the power of the Holy Spirit, that relationship means indeed we did share in His glory, in the resurrection, but also in His cross. You can't do one without the other. And that means that you're really interconnected, as you know, as the body of Christ. And we are the body of Christ. And that means that we have the power of forgiveness. We have the power of creation. We have the power of love. And sometimes it appears to be all bundled up like a ball of string. That's how it seems to be across America now, because we find it so hard to love one another. At least some people do. They just find it so hard. And part of it is a stubborn refusal that it's always been that way. They don't want anything to change, and they're certainly not trying to induce any change for the better. When people ask me, how could God allow that? I just can only think, He must not stop crying these days. Jesus wept over Jerusalem, and I'm sure He's weeping over the world. We're weeping over the world. It's not the way the Creator meant it to be. So I think as we share the body of Christ tonight, and frequently as we do throughout our own life, I think each one of us can ask ourselves, how am I doing as a reflection of the body of Christ? And when others see me, with whatever I'm into, how do they find me, knowing that I proclaim to be a member of Christ's body here on earth? It's an awful great experience to be members of the body of Christ and therefore united with one another. Let's stand. Lord, open our hearts, lead us to the center of your heart, the center of joy in our world. Fill us with a sense of grace as we offer you these petitions.
For the church, that through our sharing in the Eucharist, we may be transformed more and more into the body of Christ. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For governmental and civic leaders, that God will give them wisdom to address the unrest, insight into righting injustices, and words that will unite society. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For our parish community, that we, body and drink the one cup of Christ's blood, may pour out our lives more generously in mutual service. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For all who are ill and those who care for them, that God will send healing to the sick, strength and wisdom to care providers, and inspiration to those researching treatments and vaccines. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For all the faithful departed, especially Frida and David, for whom this Mass is offered, may they be raised up on the last day to live forever. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
Gracious Lord, hear these prayers and all the prayers of our heart through Christ our Lord.
Amen. May the Lord accept the sacrifice at your hands for the praise and glory of his name, for our good and good of all this holy church.
Lord, grant your church the gifts of unity and peace, whose signs are to be seen in the mystery and the offering here present, through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your hearts.
We lift them up to the Lord.
And let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right and just.
God our Father, all over the world, your people are praising you. So now we join with all the people of the church, with Francis, our Holy Father, Robert, our Bishop, in heaven, the Blessed Virgin Mary, our husband Joseph, the apostles, St. Rose of Lima, and all those who sing your praise. Now we join with them and with all the angels and saints to adore you as we sing. Then we can offer to you what you have given to us. The night before he died, Jesus was having supper with his apostles. He took bread in his hands. He gave him thanks and praise. Then he broke the bread, gave it to his friends, and said, "Take this, all of you, and eat it. This is my body, which will be given up for you." When the supper ended, he took the cup filled with wine. Again he gave him thanks and praise. He gave the cup to his friends and said, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it. For this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and everlasting covenant. It will be shed for you and the many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." The mystery of faith.
Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil.
Deliver us, Lord, from every kind of evil, and graciously grant us peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy we will always be free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ.
For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours, now and forever.
Lord Jesus, you said to your friends, "I leave you peace, my peace I give you. Look not on our sins, but on the faith of your people, and grant us the peace and unity of your kingdom, where you live forever and ever."
Amen.
May the peace of the Lord be with you always.
And with your spirit.
Let's offer our neighbors some sign of Christ's peace.
Thank you.
Jesus, who comes to take away the sin of the world, happy are those called to share in the supper of the Lamb.
Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof, but only say the word, and my soul shall be healed.
If you're new to the caution center in place during the Mass, it's just a communion time, and usher will back up and rattle your pews. He or she will give you a little squirt of the good sanitizer that we have. Just approach either using giving out communion. Please take communion in your hand as you stretch out your hands like that. And you don't have to be like that. It's a little more awkward just to stretch out your hands formally. And then just keep walking to your left or right and lift your mask and take communion. Just go back to your seats. And then the ushers are going to kindly go down the aisle. So they're coming up the aisle at the end of the mass, so the rear can go first.
Thank you.
Let us pray. Loving God, we pray that we may always delight for all eternity in that share in your own divine life, which is foreshadowed in the present age by our reception of your Holy Communion, who lives and reigns with you forever and ever.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Always grateful to Rick and his staff for all the good they do, and I hope cheering you all up and singing with your heart. That all will be well. I think that's a beautiful prayer by Saint Julian of Norwich. Julian of Norwich, very simplest prayer, my favorite prayer. All will be well, all will be well. Two repetitions of that. Things are beginning to happen. I urge you to read our Facebook, our website. You know, the school department is beginning to talk about school and what are the options going to be and how are they going to do it. So we're right up against the door listening so that we can follow suit with our religious education program. Generally by this time of the year, our registration would be out, but it's sort of a wait and see type of thing. But what we do know and can be confident in is that everyone is working for the good of the other. So everyone is really doing a good job, and they deserve lots of credit. We're going to have our first confirmation. We're lining up confirmation first, and then first communion, since we're behind in everything, right? So nothing will be cuter than our kids with their little white masks on, getting ready for Holy Communion. We want them to be really comfortable, and so we're designing some type of great mass that will bring them not only safety, but excitement and joy. We have three confirmations this year. The first is going to be this Friday night, I think, right?
Saturday.
So this is Saturday, Friday night rehearsal. So pray for us and pray for you, and keep in touch. If you have any questions about us, all the information in the bulletin, just call any of us at any time. And may Almighty God bless you, the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Our Mass is now ended. Let us go and bring God's love in our communion wherever we go.
Thanks be to God.